Let's explore a problem that can happen if you have not applied the patch that's provided for accessing the access databases. So you go to start a new project that you're going to do some LINQ databases connectivity in, and you come up and create a new data source. You say add new data source, and it's going to be a new database, and you're going to create a new data set, and you want a new connection. It's going to be a Microsoft Access database file using the .NET framework data provider for Ole. And we go to continue, and then we browse and we find the database that we want to use. And we say test the connection. This is an unrecognized database format. This doesn't work. Okay, so we haven't got the update for the .NET framework in place and the JET Access database engine that uses the ACCDB format. So what we have would work probably with the older MDB format, but that's not what we have to do. So we need to install the provider for the JET Access database engine. JET is the name, the code name for the project that Microsoft calls Microsoft Access. It's the JET development team internally. Okay. So clearly we need to do an update. I'm going to go ahead and just cancel this for the moment, and I'm going to minimize my project, and I'm going to open the browser. And I'm going to go over to pipeline. Log in. I'm going to go into Canvas. Into my 119 Canvas course shell. And if I scroll down here under the current week, there is the assignment 13 patch. And provider is not registered on the local machine error. We're getting something sort of similar. Let's give this a try and see if this solves our problem. So we'll go ahead and download this. And I'm going to put that in my CIS 119 directory, and I'll call this database patch. Doesn't really matter what you name it. Just remember where it is. And I'm going to save it. And then once it is concluded downloading, I'm going to run it. And it's the Access Database Engine 2010 setup wizard. And we're going to say next. I'm going to accept the terms. And next, I'm going to take the default and install. And say OK. So at this point, I should be done with my browser. I'm just going to go ahead and close that. And I should be done with that patch. I'm going to minimize that for now. I can open it again later if needed. And let's come up and see if a restart is necessary, either a restart of the application or restart of the whole machine. So let's go ahead and try our data source now. So add a new data source, and it's a database. And creating a new data set. It's going to be a new connection to an Access database file using the .NET Ole provider. Nothing changed there. And let's browse over to our database and see if we're able to open it and test the connection now. So still the same problem. So let's go ahead and see if restarting the project will cause the environment variables to be reread. And we'll try restarting here. And create a new project. It's going to be a Windows Form project. And I'm just going to take the default name for the time being. OK. And let's try reconnecting the data source. Add a new data source. Database, data set, new connection, and database, access database file. And let's go take a look. And there's a database file, and test the connection. And now it's happy. So we did need to restart Visual Studio and say OK and next. And yes, make a local copy in my project of that database. That's a good thing to do. And save that connection. That's fine. I'm going to add all the tables. I think there's only one in that particular database. And finish. And now that I've got my data source, if I simply drag the data source or the data set onto the form, the wizards will do all kinds of great and wonderful things in making the navigator for me and adding a data grid. And I should have basically a runnable program. Let's go ahead and run it and confirm that everything really is working properly. And there's my linked data in the data set, and I can navigate down the records, and I can navigate up the records, and it looks like we're in good shape. And so that's what you do to resolve that problem.